Welcome to Lab 360, it's time to explore. Y'all must have heard how the James Webb Space Telescope is contradicting the Big Bang theory with its recent findings. It is as if suddenly, we have no idea about the origin of our universe. How did the universe come into being, if not the Big Bang? Our understanding of the cosmos is rapidly evolving since the launch of the Webb Telescope. We are unfolding the universe like never before, and soon, we will look at exoplanets, the potentially habitable ones, to find out if life exists outside of our planet. Webb will look at the TRAPPIST system, and the Centaurus constellation, to examine Proxima Centauri. And sooner, we will find out if we are alone, or not. But on a quest for finding extraterrestrial life, are we ignoring our oceans? Is the focus too much on outer space? Let's begin with a true story from the archives. As the Soviet Union disintegrated, the Russian Navy declassified its records of Cold War UFO sightings. The reports suggested that 50% of UFO encounters were connected with oceans, while 15% with lakes. The reports stressed that the UFOs tended to stick to the water. And that makes a lot of sense. Life as we know it depends on water. And water could be the only common thing between us and the aliens. The radars on Russian submarines, on several occasions, gave readings of material objects moving at incredible speeds. Calculations showed speeds of about 230 knots, or 400 kilometers per hour. Speeding so fast is a challenge, even on the surface. Whatever they were, defied our laws of physics. Russian Navy personnels were left scratching their heads, for they knew that it wasn't US or any other country spying on their waters. According to a Russian Navy intelligence veteran, ocean UFOs often showed up wherever there, or NATO's fleets concentrated. Near Bahamas, Bermudas, and Puerto Rico. They are still most often seen in the deepest part of the Atlantic Ocean, in the southern part of the Bermuda Triangle, and also in the Caribbean Sea. Another place where people often report UFO encounters is Russia's Lake Baikal, the deepest freshwater body in the world. Fishermen tell of powerful lights coming from the deep, and objects flying up from the water. In one case in 1982, a group of military divers training at Baikal spotted a group of humanoid creatures dressed in silvery suits. The encounter happened at a depth of 50 meters, and the divers tried to catch the strangers. While doing so, three of the seven men died, while four others were severely injured. Meanwhile, we all know about the mysterious events that has happened in the region of Bermuda Triangle over the years, before they almost suddenly stopped. Now, mystery holes have been spotted on ocean floor, that is baffling scientists. These holes were discovered by oceanographers earlier this year, and they have no idea what made them, or how they came about. However, UFO experts are certain that the strange markings are proof of alien visits. We have long suspected aliens are using the ocean as a way of staying out of the way and exploring the Earth on their own terms. These holes simply cannot be explained any other way, as they appear closely aligned in a regularly repeating pattern with tiny piles of sediment piled around them. Anna Whitty, the author of UFOs, A Fundamental Truth, previously said that it is likely aliens have always been here and are living under the sea for protection. She claimed that by doing this, they would escape disasters that devastate the globe every several thousand years, meaning they are more protected, and their technology and intelligence could continue on an upwards trajectory. The holes were found by the crew of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration's Explorer vessel, as they investigated the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, a mostly unexplored region of the seafloor, which is part of the world's largest mountain range. But this is not the first time the mysterious spots have been seen. Marine scientists from the U.S. National Marine Fisheries Service also spotted the bizarre hollows in the ocean floor during a dive in 2004. NOAA researchers said, these holes have been previously reported in the region, but their origin remains a mystery. While they almost look human-made, the little piles of sediment around the holes make them seem like they were excavated by something. Our oceans and other water bodies are perfect hideouts for them, because we only know 5% of ocean. Comparatively, we know more about the surface of the Moon, or Mars, than our own oceans. This is perfect place for them to hide and thrive. Think about it. Earth is one hell of a lucky planet. In 4.5 billion years, our planet has survived almost every existential threat, except a supernova. It supposedly took a beating from another protoplanet, when it was a protoplanet itself, and still has the remnants of that collision, deep in its mantle. Through all the cosmic trauma it has experienced, from its violent birth, to asteroids throwing lethal punches, that wiped out more than just the dinosaurs, but Earth, held up. Not to mention that our Sun is a middle-aged star, which hasn't gone red giant and swallowed us up.
We have at least another 7 to 8 billion years before it opens its fiery jaws and comes for us.
Also, since humans are merely infants compared to the first multicellular beings on the planet, maybe there are beings living deep inside our waters who aren't aliens at all. They might be children of this planet too. And they might have evolved to live underwater, whereas us Homo sapiens chose to live on land. There is also the question of how strange the world would be like in the depths of the oceans. Imagine all the flora and fauna we would discover if we could just get around the rest of Earth for a while, never mind the universe. But if the universe at all follows the pattern like in our solar system, with most worlds having oceans on the inside, those oceans are probably more stable environments to life. Most of the life that would evolve would be in those oceans, and completely sequestered from knowing there's a universe. The James Webb Space Telescope recently captured some stunning images of Jupiter. And very soon, it will turn its powerful eye on two of the solar system's top candidates for hosting alien life: the icy moons, Enceladus, and Europa. Both Europa, a moon of Jupiter, and Enceladus, a moon of Saturn, are thought to possess subsurface oceans of liquid water, beneath thick outer layers of ice. Both moons have also shown evidence of enormous plumes of liquid, shooting up through cracks in the surface ice. These plumes could be caused by subsurface geysers, which could provide a source of heat and nutrients to life forms there, scientists have said. And while we scan the cosmos, humanity still has to develop means to reach the deepest parts of our oceans. This should keep us grounded, this should keep us humble. And if there is an advanced or alien civilization underwater, maybe we should just leave them alone, for if they wanted to be found, they would have made sure it happened long back. What do you guys think? Drop in your comments to let us know, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for more such videos from the world of astronomy.